Hi, AT from CNC at home. Over the last few months, I've noticed an issue with the laser. When the gantry moves all the way to one side, it tends to lose power. And I've determined that there's a bad connection on the main power lead that goes from the rear control panel up to the laser's control panel. It's a three-wire run that comes up there and provides power. And when it goes all the way to one side, there's a bad connection, and then the entire gantry loses power. So in this video, I'm going to do some investigation to see if I can track down what the issue is and see if there's an easy solution. If not, that means I'm going to probably have to either hardwire that in, it's a plug where the issue seems to be, or I will need to put a new plug on there, and that may not be as easy as it sounds either. Anyway, let's go take a look at what's happening with the laser and then dig into that control board, see if we can diagnose where the problem's happening and go from there, see what we can do. I certainly would appreciate it if you'd give this video a thumbs up. That helps the YouTube analytics drive more viewers to the channel, and that helps the channel out. Let's take a quick look at the laser. And we move it over to the right, we'll see that nothing seems to happen. But when we move to the left, power is cut. Just a simple touch in the back on the wiring harness, power is restored. So there's definitely a connection issue there. I'm going to take this probe and just push around on the wires and on the plug to see if I can determine where the issue is. I was able to get the power to cut, and now I'm trying to see what actually makes it come back on. Okay, there we have the power back on. It's at the bottom of the plug, which happens to be the black wire. Yep, that's it. Taking a look at the laser control board, I noticed that it was pretty dirty, so I got some compressed air and blew that out. On that red plug, there's a red, white, and black wire, and it's that black one that seems to be the issue. Let's take a closer look. I do have a plug kit, so if need be, I can remake a plug, and this does fit in that socket. I want to disassemble this laser control board. I'll be removing those four bolts. I can take a closer look then at that red plug. It's possible that there's a cracked or broken solder connection. Upon closer inspection, the solder joints actually looked pretty good. That center one did have some lifting in the front of it on the solder joint. It didn't look like a crack, it just looked like it was peeled up somehow. To ensure that that's actually connected well, I'm just getting the soldering iron out, and I'm just going to re-solder that real quick. Get the solder hot, let it flow back into the connection. The next step is to reassemble the laser controller back into its holder and get that mounted back up onto the gantry. There's just these two screws that hold that on, so we'll get those back on. The next thing I'd like to test are the wires, that black, white, and red wire. So I've got my multimeter out and some fancy little probes here. I'm going to connect onto the red wire, then the white, and then the black. Make sure that the electricity is flowing through there, the continuity is good on the wire. All three tested well. So I'm just going to plug everything back into the controller and see if anything's changed. We haven't done anything. So I'm assuming nothing has changed. Well, in monkeying around and wiggling, everything seems to be working correctly. There's still an issue if I reach back and wiggle the wires. So I think I'll put a little hot glue on there to hold them in place, maybe a zip tie to hold that whole wiring harness down so it doesn't move so much. It turns out that there is a bad connection. I'm not sure exactly what. I believe it's on the black wire. In under close examination, there is something weird looking. It looks like that it's received some damage at some point. I don't know if that was pulled out at one point and then shoved back in, but there's definitely some scraping and deformity there on the plug. Anyway, I put some hot glue on the wires to kind of hold them in place to see if that would fix it. It kind of does, but it really doesn't work any better than it did before. So the solution is going to end up being replacing that plug either with the same plug or similar. I do have a plug kit, as we saw, and that does fit on the control circuit, the laser control board, and I could replace with that, or I could just solder those wires right on, which might be the better thing because it's not coming on and off. There's no reason for it to be plugged on. So, and that would be simpler than creating a new plug. Trust me, those aren't easy to do. Thank you for watching the video. Remember to give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And if you like our content, think about subscribing to the channel. That helps us out with the YouTube analytics and drives more people to watch our videos. Have fun doing your CNC at home projects.